killer trees. Have you heard anything about them? They explode, release toxic juices, and can sting or even cut you severely. I think it's important to know more about such plants to stay unharmed in case of an accidental encounter. So watch this video until the end and discover the truth about killer trees. Enjoy watching! Manchineel, the most dangerous tree on Earth capable of killing a person. Today I'll tell you about it. Just being under this tree during rain can cause you to develop blisters. The milky sap of the manchineel contains potent toxins causing allergic dermatitis. Burning the tree is also dangerous, as the smoke, if in contact with the eyes, can lead to blindness. The fruits of this plant can be deadly, causing nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and seizures, hence the name, Little Apple of Death. Due to its properties, it has entered the Guinness World Records as the most dangerous tree globally. The plant's sap can even burn through lightweight cotton clothing. Avoid being near this tree in any weather, as the sap drips down from the leaves with raindrops and spreads with the wind. Consuming the apple-like fruits is particularly dangerous as they contain the highest concentration of the intoxicating toxin. The esophagus and the stomach can be burned from the inside of the poison. Despite its danger, this tree has found useful applications. The plant sap is used in medicine to study malignant tumors. Additionally, there are daring enthusiasts who value honey from manchineel flowers. However, most often, this deadly tree is used in furniture making. Before felling the tree, loggers set fires around it to dry it most effectively. Even after this, cutting is done with caution, since sawdust still poses a danger. Finished furniture made from manchineel is entirely harmless thanks to special processing that completely eliminates traces of poisonous fluids. Label 3. Gimpi-gimpi. I also learned about the Gimpi-gimpi plant. It is also known as the stinging tree. It is a large shrub from the nettle family. Although this plant is related to the nettle and causes a burn, the experience of contact with it can be very unpleasant. The name stinging tree is possibly given due to its ability to cause unpleasant burns. Gimpi-gimpi is a stem that grows 3 to 6 feet tall with large heart-shaped leaves measuring 7 to 8 inches. The fruits of this plant resemble those of a fig tree, but they're not edible. If you touch Gimpi-gimpi, you are in for a very unpleasant surprise. The skin that comes into contact with the plant's leaves turns red spots, which gradually turn into swelling. However, the most concerning is the burn, which causes unbearable pain. People who have experienced the effect of this plant describe the sensations as a mixture of a burn from concentrated acid with electric shocks. The pain not only does not disappear over time, but intensifies and acquires new shades. Some people suffer from these sensations for several days, others for several weeks or even months. Pain relievers do not always help. Victims of Gimpi-gimpi recount that after several days of suffering, they start contemplating suicide because it is unbearable to endure this burning. Apart from humans, this plant is also dangerous for horses, dogs, and cats, which die from burns every year. For scientists, Gimpi-gimpi is of great interest. By studying its toxin gimpeted, they hope to find a remedy for burns caused by this plant as well as for poisons of other animals and plants with similar effects. Perhaps Gimpi-gimpi will help create an antidote to the venom of box jellyfish, which claims the lives of swimmers every year off the coast of Australia and New Guinea. Another plant I covered in my video belongs to the Euphorbiaceae family and is known as the exploding Hura. This plant has gained dubious fame, although it is not capable of killing a person, but can cause a lot of problems. The leaves of this plant, known as the dynamite tree, closely resemble lilac leaves. They are approximately the same size and have a heart shape. However, Hura can grow up to 80 feet in height and up to 7 feet in girth, distinguishing it from the ordinary milkweed, which is often grown indoors. The flowering of the Hura tree only begins after reaching a height of 16 feet, unlike most other plants where flowering depends on age or season. When looking at the dynamite tree from a distance, it appears majestic and picturesque, with a wide crown and lush green leaves. However, upon closer inspection, it becomes apparent that the trunk and large branches of the tree are covered with sharp thorns. Another inconvenient feature of Hura is its problematic fruits. They look like small pumpkins and pose a danger, not because of their ability to fall on the head, but because they can explode. When the Hura fruits ripen, they dry out and then suddenly burst with a loud crack, scattering at speeds of up to 157 miles per hour. Such seed dispersal speed allows them to spread as far as possible and grow into new plants. And finally, another feature of Hura is its poisonous sap. Poisoning with Hura sap is accompanied by rapid heartbeat, weakness, vomiting, deafness, and impaired vision. The symptoms of poisoning completely incapacitate a person for a long time. I found a description stating that in ancient times, the yew tree was considered the tree of death. If you slept under it, you might not wake up. Yew is one of the longest living organisms on Earth. Some specimens live over 2,000 years. The tree contains a poisonous substance that can cause heart failure. The yew needle is also toxic and can be dangerous to various animals. Yew seeds are particularly dangerous if chewed beforehand. If this happens, it always leads to a lethal outcome for both humans and animals. Symptoms of yew poisoning include difficulty walking, muscle tremors, seizures, difficulty breathing, chills, and heart failure. Although yew is highly valued by woodworking masters, there is evidence that some bow makers were poisoned by toxins from yew due to prolonged contact with the wood. And do not confuse this poison with toxins, they have differences. It is necessary to seriously weigh all the risks before using yew in landscaping, especially if there are children or pets in the vicinity. The next story in my video tells about Chilibuha, also known as the vomiting nut. This tree thrives in tropical and subtropical climates. However, its fame is due not only to its appearance but also to its seeds, which contain a poisonous substance, strychnine. It is this substance that gives the seed a bitter taste. Strychnine has a negative impact on the central nervous system and can cause disturbances in its functioning. Chilibuha's height can reach 16 to 50 feet with its twisted and thick trunk. Young plants often have thorns on their stems. Interestingly, already in the Middle Ages, strychnine was used as a poison to combat rodents. But resourceful medical students of the 19th century went further and even used this poison to combat drowsiness. In England, pub owners decided to try enriching their drink and added strychnine, which gave the drink a bitter taste similar to hops and enhanced intoxication. However, such an experiment led to numerous cases of poisoning, and it had to be discontinued. Nevertheless, Chilibuha has certain properties that can be successfully used in medicine to treat various diseases. Therefore, preparation based on this plant are used only under strict medical supervision. I will also tell you that there is a belief associated with the castor bean plant. It is said that its presence in summer cottages repels flies and mosquitoes. However, despite such usefulness, the castor bean plant is one of the most dangerous plants on Earth. Its fruits and sap contain ricin, for which there is no antidote. Castor bean seeds indeed resemble ticks with all their menacing appearance. The stems of this decorative plant can reach a height of 7 to 10 feet, and cut leaves can have a diameter of up to half a meter and are colored green, red-brown, or purple, depending on the variety. It's interesting to note that castor bean began to be cultivated from ancient times. Its seeds were found in the tombs of Egyptian pharaohs. The plant was widely used to obtain castor oil. Consuming castor bean leaves can cause the death of domestic livestock. Chickens that eat the seeds are at risk of poisoning. Symptoms of ricin poisoning do not manifest instantly, making this plant particularly dangerous. It can be challenging for a person to link the consumption of the plant with subsequent poisoning. Moreover, children may accidentally forget about consuming the seeds. The first symptoms of poisoning may appear only after 1 to 2 days. Even a small scratch in the skin becomes a path into the body, leading to inevitable death.